Hey Kingsman, welcome back to another week of PNN. I'm your anchor, Madison Reinbarger.
And I'm Timer Gruder. Let's get into your news and announcements for today, Saturday, May 9th, 2020.
Wait, what? There's still another week and 2 days until summer break. I guess that means I have to keep doing my e-learning. Wait, what? If I'm in an AP class, I need to get my testing hat on and get aboard the testing express. Woo, woo! Because while most classes don't have regular final exams, AP classes still have their AP tests. Darn. If you need some information on it, Mr. Hall has sent out some emails. You can check the College Board website, or you can check the PNN website for information.
Students can complete their tests on a variety of devices, but the school-issued Chromebook is the most recommended. AP students will also need to log into their test 30 minutes prior to their scheduled testing time to be situated and ready to go when the test begins. Each test will be 45 minutes long with a 5-minute period for submission.
Now I can take off my testing hat and give you some other good news. So Ball State hosts their J Day every year, which stands for Journalism Day, and the competition results just came out, and so we have some exciting news. We won not one, not two, but 8 awards. So first off, we have our show from the week before Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving, Christmas, same thing, the week before winter break. Go watch it on our YouTube channel. And Tyler won an award about his story about the Magic Wheelchair Project, which got an excellent rating. And his story about our English class sizes got a superior award. Good job, Ty.
In addition, Madison's mental health story and Elizabeth Rothsell's story about Mark Wood's show with the orchestra received honorable mentions. Penn earned honorable mentions for our Instagram feed, homepage, and our show 28 as well.
This is such great news for PNN. I can't wait to get back to school and hang up those awards in our newsroom.
Me too, Madison. I'm glad to know that even though our workshop day was canceled, we were still able to celebrate. Now let's head on over to Josh Wyatt for this week's weather update.
Hi, school. It's your PNN weatherman, Josh Wyatt, with this week's update on the weather. Today's May 8th. It will be partly cloudy and windy, with a high of 48 degrees and a low of 28. Tomorrow, Saturday, May 9th, will be sunny with a high of 54 degrees and low of 42. And on Sunday, May 10th, it will be rainy with 54 degrees as the high temps and 34 as the low. And this week, we can expect some sunny days between Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and some showers and AM showers and PM showers on Thursday and Friday. Well, that's all I have for you, Penn High School.
Thank you, Josh. Hopefully these temperatures go up, because I can't even pretend it's summer when these temperatures are so low.
Well, this seems to be the end of our show, Penn. For more news and announcements, you can check out our award-winning website at pnn.phmschools.org or our award-winning Instagram feed at Penn News Network.
Thank you for joining us. Have a great weekend, Penn High School. Make sure to stay safe and finish the school year out strong, even if you have to put this testing hat on. Bye!